Hello, and thank you as ever for joining me. What is the real reason for the West prolonging the war in Ukraine? Regardless of what the Western ruling elites say on television or on radio or write in newspapers, in private they know that they have lost the war in Ukraine. They are acutely aware that the so-called counter-offensive of the Ukrainian army has been a catastrophic failure, incurring the deaths of in excess of 50,000 Ukrainian soldiers and the destruction of hundreds upon hundreds of armored vehicles, many of which were from NATO countries, such as American Bradley fighting vehicles and German Leopard tanks. And the Western ruling elites are acutely conscious that the so-called Ukrainian counter-offensive, which is in its fifth month now, has not even resulted in Ukrainian forces advancing anywhere close to the first line of Russian defences. Indeed, the so-called Ukrainian counter-offensive, which is one of the worst planned military actions in recent times, for Ukrainian ground forces have no air cover whatsoever, has resulted in only a few kilometers of land having been captured by the Ukrainians. Furthermore, the Western ruling elites are acutely aware that so far in the war, approximately 500,000 Ukrainian soldiers have died, with many more having been wounded. Accordingly, the West knows that its Ukrainian army cannot and will not win the war. Thus, the question which inevitably arises is, why are the Western ruling elites prolonging the war? It is at this stage that I should say that the Western ruling elites are, of course, not providing military and financial support to the Ukrainian government in order to defend democracy, freedom, international law, and the security of Europe. Only the very worst kind of simpleton would believe such absurd and crude propaganda. Now, returning to the aforesaid question as to why the West is continuing the war in Ukraine, well, there are a number of plausible explanations. So, for instance, in the hope that the longer the war continues, the more chance there is of the Russian economy being harmed to such an extent that the Kremlin would not be able to continue its military campaign in Ukraine. Also, in the hope that the longer the war continues, this could turn Russian public opinion against the war, which in turn could menace the survival of the Russian government. Then there are the informal, yet very well publicized business ties between the Biden family and the Ukrainian government. All three of those possible explanations have a ring of plausibility to them, especially the last one concerning the Biden family's interests in Ukraine. However, I am of the opinion that the first two possible explanations are somewhat dubious, because those who comprise the heart of the Western ruling elites, the people who are, largely speaking, unknown of in public, are intellectually superior beings. Western politicians, journalists, and so-called experts in universities, think tanks, and NGOs are merely useful idiots. And idiots they are. But those who are at the heart of the Western ruling elites are very, very different. It follows, therefore, that those at the heart of the Western ruling elites are, undoubtedly, aware that far from damaging the Russian economy, the war in Ukraine and the ensuing Western sanctions have resulted in Russia's economy attaining the status of a much enhanced global powerhouse. Indeed, the Russian economy is now the largest and most powerful it has been in the post-Soviet period. And there is no tangible evidence at all to suggest that this will change in the foreseeable future. Further to that, those at the heart of the Western ruling elites will be familiar with the Russian national character, hence they are cognizant of an empirical historical fact. Namely, when the Russian motherland is threatened, the Russian people make whatever sacrifices are necessary to ensure the victory of Russia, including sacrificing the lives of millions of themselves. In short, the Russian national character is completely different to Western national characters. Outside of the Western world, the Japanese national character is one which can be compared to its Russian equivalent. Now, returning to why it is that the Western ruling elites are continuing to prosecute an unwinnable war, I have a possible explanation which I consider to be quite probable. I shall now offer to you my submission. Knowing that the war is lost, and knowing that the lands which comprise Ukraine will be absorbed into the Russian Federation, the West, by prolonging the war, is attempting to cause the Kremlin a demographic and economic crisis in the lands which it will one day control. So, by the Western ruling elites instructing its puppet government in Kiev to enlist more and more men into the Ukrainian army, this will only result in the numbers of males in Ukraine continuing to drastically decrease, as many of these new conscripts will die in combat. Accordingly, after more regions in Ukraine are incorporated into the Russian Federation, following their capture by the Russian army, such as Odessa, Dnipropetrovsk, Kharkov, Zhytomyr, and Vinnytsia, the Kremlin will discover that there is a major absence of males in these regions. A major absence of males will pose a twofold problem for the Russian government. Firstly, the birth rate in these regions will be severely impacted because there will be an absence of men for women with whom to breed with. Hence, a demographic crisis in parts of the new Russia will have been born. And secondly, a demographic crisis will inevitably and negatively impact economic productivity in the newly acquired regions, and thereby the Russian economy as a whole, as there will be a shortage of men to work in factories, mines, and on farms, and so on. Thus, the industrial and agricultural sectors in the newly acquired regions will have a profound shortage of male labor. So, in colloquial English, the Western ruling elites will say to the Russian government the following: you may have got Ukraine, but what good is land if it comes without many males residing on it? In concluding, therefore, it is quite probable that the West is seeking to ensure that Russia's inevitable victory in the war in Ukraine will be a poisoned chalice for the Kremlin. Thank you again for joining me, and I hope you will be able to join me in my next video.